Yo, what is up, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to another episode of our NCAA Football 14 Iowa Sim-Only Dynasty. If you missed the first episode, I really explained what the series was about and brought us into the season. But in the meantime, we simmed through week two, and we got a big victory against Western Michigan. Actually, only a 36-21 victory, thanks to a 20-0 shutout in the fourth quarter by the Iowa Hawkeyes. Really a close game throughout the whole entire first half and actually three quarters. A 97-yard run by Ellaby really gave them some momentum, but Makai Sargent, Smith Marset, TJ Hawkinson, all with touchdowns in that fourth quarter. And a good win. We ended up with 418 passing yards on the day, 200 yards on the ground. They had 266 yards on the ground. So defensively up front, it's really going to have to improve, especially when we watch our game today, which is going to be against Iowa State, who's a very good team and has a very good running back by the name of David Montgomery. You might know him as an NFL draft prospect. Talk about a couple of those last episode. Well, they're not going to stop because my favorite wide receiver in the draft, Hakeem Butler, is also going to be in this game. And he is a top NFL draft prospect. So we'll have to see what plays out here in episode two, but a nice start to the episode, being 2-0, ranked number 19. As you see, we get a few sacks there, and the pick was by Amani Hooker, another NFL draft prospect. So once again, 1 out of 2 for Racinos from kicking. I need him to step it up in the kicking game. We're really going to need that down the line, especially since that's a big part of our game, you know, just getting as many points as we can and really playing to the hands of our defense. But you saw Stanley, 20 for 34, 418 yards and 3 touchdowns. Amir Smith Marset with another big day. Here's a little update on the recruiting, just some of the top schools. Haven't changed any of the points around because, once again, it's early. I have a lot of points up to the top players. Like I said, the first, you know, 5 or 6 weeks, it's kind of a mess. The board's moving around like crazy. It really starts to balance itself out as we get to the midway through the season. You really start to get, you know, your recruiting visits and really, you know, kind of lay down who's going where, and you kind of get an idea of what their top choices are. So once again, if you have any suggestions where other points should go and who we should prioritize, put that in the comment section. I'll definitely get to it as we get midway through the season. At the end of this, we'll probably be about 4 games in, I believe. We're going to watch this game against Iowa State, probably sim through the Rutgers game, and then we'll be in the thick of it with the Big Ten race. So here we come, Iowa versus Iowa State, the Cy-Hawk Trophy is on the line. Always a big game every single year. Iowa has dominated the past few years, but the games have been increasingly closer and closer as it goes on. Iowa State, as you've seen them grow throughout the past few years, have become a very legitimate team playing in the Big 12, competing at the top of that conference. So nothing's going to be easy here on the road for the Iowa Hawkeyes, and we're going to have to make some plays as Kyler Kemp has his receiver on the outside, who drops it, sets up a 3rd and 6 for Kyler Kemp. The pressure comes, he checks it down, and they're going to get the first down. Kohler fights his way for the first down, and here's David Montgomery with the second carry of the day. It's a nice gain of 9 there by Montgomery. It's 2nd and 1, play action to Montgomery. Kemp scrambling, no pressure at all, and that's going to be a slide and a first down for Kyler Kemp. It's going to be 1st and 10 now. Kemp dropping back once again. He checks this one down left side. He's going to find his tight end once again for a 4-yard reception. 2nd and 6. Handoff David Montgomery with a lot of room. Stiff arming. He's going to pick up 5. 3rd and 2. It's going to be a read option, and Kemp's going to keep it. Run through Riley Moss there, but he's still going to get the first down, 6 yards there. It's 1st and 10 now. Kemp's keeping it once again. He's going to get another nice game. He's getting his dose of carries here, 11 yards, 1st and 10. Kemp dropping back, throwing left side. He's going to find his receiver there. Stiff arm and 1st down inside the 15. It skates. 1st and 10. Keeping it once again, the read option. This time he's hit, ball side fumble. Iowa picks it up and gets a turnover in the red zone. That was Brent's knocking it out, and that's a big-time play. We're really putting all of our attention on David Montgomery, so Kemp's had quite a bit of carries here on the first possession, but that time he coughs it up, and the Iowa defense gets a much-needed stop in the red zone. Here we're going to check it down to Hawkinson. He's not going to go down easy. He's going to break off 2 tackles, pick up 6 yards. Now 2nd and 4, a little halfback counter. It's Makai Sargent, 8 yards. Now it's going to be Stanley, the one keeping on the read option. He runs through a defender. He's going to pick up 6 yards of his own. It's 2nd and 4 now. He's going to hand it off to the single back, Makai Sargent, on the outside. He's going to break a tackle. He's going to break another tackle, get to the 40, a 12-yard rush, and a 1st down. Shotgun set. It's going to be Stanley checking it down to Sargent on the screenplay. We love these screenplays here. And Mekhi Sargent makes the most of them. 19-yard reception on that screenplay. First and 10, single back once again. It's Torn Young this time, though. He's going to stiff arm his way forward for a nice run of 14 yards. Third and 10, however, at the 25, it's Stanley dropping back. Looking, pressure's coming. Breaks off of one, but is sacked. Loses 10, and that's going to make this field goal. We've had our troubles with Racinos, but the 51-yarder is up, and it is good. He has the leg. I know he does. He just has to find that accuracy here. And we're going to be simming now this drive by the Cyclones. It's going to be a 21-yard pickup to Eaton, an 8-yard rush by Montgomery, an 8-yard rush by Montgomery again, and it's a 2nd and 1 from inside the 10 all of a sudden. So Iowa State with the ball. They've had a nice drive last time but couldn't finish it off. This time they find Hakeem Butler for 5. It's 2nd and goal now. Here's Kemp dropping back. Pressure comes. Throws it left side out of the back of the end zone. Incomplete. 3rd and goal. Shotgun set. Hand off David Montgomery. He's going to get in between two defenders. And he's going to get into the end zone for the touchdown, the 3-yard touchdown rush, and the score. So our offense is on the field. A 3rd and 14 pass is going to be dropped by Amir Smith-Marset. And we do nothing on our offense with the ball trying to respond. But Iowa State's going to continue the drive on this defense. 11 yards of Montgomery. All of a sudden, it's 2nd and 10 in the red zone once again. We get a nice stop there. Sets up a nice 3rd and long. 3rd and 9. Shotgun. Kemp dropping back, throwing over the middle. He finds his receiver. Receiver breaks one, but is taken down at the 10. It's going to be a 4th and 2, and they kick the field goal. So the offense once again back on the field. We get a 1st down here. A few handoffs there to Sargent. But on 3rd and 2, Stanley is taken down for a loss. But Iowa State can't do anything with the ball either. And Iowa's taken over around midfield. Our best field position here so far. On the day, we got to take advantage of it, but Stanley throws it into double coverage and is almost picked off. A 1:40 to play here at 2nd and 10. Stanley, just awkward, not great. First 2 weeks, he was on fire. This one so far, nothing great. 3rd and 10, trying to make something happen on the screenplay, but Mekhi Sargent runs out of room there on the sideline. Only a 4-yard gain, and we punt the ball back. We pin them deep inside their own territory, inside their 5, but David Montgomery is going to pick up 6 there. And on 2nd and 4, the pressure comes. He's hit as he throws, but it doesn't matter. It's a 7-yard reception for the tight end. Now 2nd and inches, we bring the blitz again. This time, Hawkeyes is going to get to him. It's a loss of 5 for Kyler Kemp. And that's going to take us to the half, actually. They decided to run it out for the half. We didn't have any problems with that, as it was an ugly first half for our offense. And as soon as we come out in the second half, we get the kick and we fumble it, recovered by Iowa State at our 12-yard line. Amir Smith-Marset, our kick returner, must have fumbled there. And I wasn't expecting that. Obviously, that's why you didn't see it. So Iowa State set up perfectly, and on 2nd and 10, they're going to take advantage of that crazy good field position. David Montgomery on a check down fights his way into the end zone. For the touchdown, you see Amir Smith-Marset clearly got benched, says Nick Easley. Took that punt return, and then we go 3 and out and punt. Hakeem Butler, 46 yards on 3rd and 2. They throw the ball away, but they get the field goal anyway, make this a 3-possession lead. Amir Smith-Marset, 25 yards. Fant, 10 yards. But then we're moving ourselves backwards there on the penalty. It's going to be a 3rd and 11. We need a 1st down here. Stanley hit as he throws. Passing complete. 9 of 18, 85 yards. This Iowa State defense is playing phenomenal right now, and this offense is just moving it with ease. David Montgomery really in the middle of it all, having himself a great day once again against Iowa. There's a sack, though, pushing him back. 3rd and 11, a chance to get a much-needed stop, and we do exactly that. Anthony Nelson off the edge. He gets a big sack once again. NFL draft prospect. A 58-yard field goal is no good, but the Iowa offense does absolutely nothing with it. And then Iowa State comes right back with a 42-yard completion and an 18-yard touchdown pass, and this thing is getting ugly in a hurry. It's 27-3 now. This Iowa offense is really going to have to get things rolling if they want any chance of even competing in this game. It's 3rd and 10 around midfield. Stanley trips on Mekhi Sargent's foot, and that's a sack, loss of 9. We'll be punting back to Iowa State. That's just that play right there probably sums up this whole entire game. in this day so far for Nate Stanley, just tripping on his own running back's foot on a drop back, just a normal drop back. But Anthony Nelson's been a bright spot in a pretty ugly day here. He gets another sack there on the offense, just trying to get any momentum to move on into Big Ten play. 27 yards and Nick Easley is a really good start with that. Third and one going to Torn Young. He gets inside the 5-yard line. Now with under 4 minutes to play, a chance of a comeback is quite the long shot. But Makai Sargent, 4-yard touchdown run. He's gonna get things going and try to give us some momentum, keeping it going. We get the 2-point conversion. We don't get the onside kick, but we'd make it a 2-possession game. And on 3rd and 6, they do not quite get it, and they miss a 52-yard field goal. So all of a sudden, there's 3 minutes to play. We're down 16, but a score here and a 2-point conversion can make things interesting, and that's a nice completion there to the outside. 3rd and 3 now. Stanley over the middle finds his receiver. It's another first down, but time is ticking. Under a minute and a half to play. 3rd and 2 for Stanley. Checking it down once again. He picks up the first down, but still, not much time left to go. We have all three timeouts, but on 1st and 10, Stanley gets hit, sacked, moves us back. You want to see another replay of it, but with a different player? Here you go. 8-yard loss, another sack, and we have to call a timeout with a minute to go. 4th and 25, Stanley throwing it deep, almost intercepted. That's incomplete, and that's going to do it for the day. Iowa State's going to get a big win for their program and their season, dominating the Iowa Hawkeyes at home, 27-11. Stanley didn't look good. Our defense was, even though they only let up 27 points, which is a lot, but I feel like it could have been at least 42 or 45, somewhere around that range. The way that Iowa State was moving it with ease, even on the first possession, they easily could have a touchdown if it wasn't for Kemp fumbling the ball. Stanley on 36 attempts, only 189 yards, and he only completed 20 passes. Kemp, however, 37 attempts, 322 yards. Montgomery didn't quite reach 100 yards, but he had a good day in the passing game. We did not, however. Nobody really had a good day at all. Hakeem Butler almost 100 yards. They had 60 out of the backfield for Montgomery. Like I said, they just moved it at ease on offense. And our offense, however, moved it nowhere at all. And a couple of big turnovers, I think, coming out of the halftime when we were down only 10-3 and we start out with a fumble getting the ball at our 12-yard line, really was a huge turning point in this game. Obviously, giving up possession, momentum like that was definitely going to be difficult, especially the way our offense had started out in the first half, only having 3 points. But we're going to sim right through that one. That's a good thing about the sim-only dynasty, is we can just keep on going. And we get a dominating win against Rutgers. Really got motivated, it looks like, and came back. Another slow start by the offense, but in the fourth quarter, where we seem to have excelled so far this year, we win that quarter 21-0. A good day in the air. It looks like we picked it back up with over 300 yards. Yep, Nate Stanley, 25-34, 306 yards and 3 touchdowns. Makai Sargent, 83 on the ground. Amir Smith-Marset, 11 catches, 191 yards and 2 scores. That's a big-time day from Smith-Marset. I need more of those days. He's the one guy that has the explosiveness to make any type of play on the field for us offensively, and we're going to have to need him to continue to do that, as he's done 3 out of the 4 games so far this year. He's had a really good day. I think he's been over 100 yards in 3 of those 4 games, at least close to it, nowhere near it against Iowa State. But we got to put that one behind us. A 3-1 start here for your Iowa Hawkeyes. Let me know what game you want to see us play live next time. But that's about all for today's episode. If you enjoyed, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe if you're new. As always, I'm out. Peace.